Anyone see?
Yeah, yes, I can see your screen. Okay.
Okay. Let's start the talk. Today, we're going to talk about probable defenses against adversarial examples about the convex outer adversarial polytopes. The author is Eric Wang. In this talk, we will involve three sessions. The first session is the introduction. We will introduce the label prediction test and the adversarial attack of label prediction test. The first session, we will talk about problem description. We will describe our network assumption and the adversarial attack on our network assumption. The last session, we will talk about our method to solve the problem, the convex relaxation method. We will introduce what is convex relaxation and why we use convex relaxation to solve the problem. So, let's start introduction. So for a prediction problem, our data set with size n can be described as SYI pair with I is the integers which from 0 to n minus 1, and YI is an integer from 0 to L minus 1. For example, SI is a grayscale feature with n pixels, and YI is the category of SY, and the total category number will be at all in the data set.
So it doesn't mean that S contains n pixels, because n is the index, you know, n is the number of samples. S contains the number of
pixel
with its cardinality.
Yes,
you in a right part, the R has a power of S of its cardinality. So it's the dimension of X, and the cardinality of S is not the is maybe can may not be equal to N. Okay.
Yes, same for its pen. And given the prediction function f theta from R cardinality of S to RL, since the output vector of f theta is dimensional, we choose the label line correspond to the greatest element of the output vector f theta of SI to be the estimation YI hat. This is f theta of SY, and we choose the element, the biggest element, the largest element, and the corresponding label with the Y is the YI hat. And the adversarial attack of the label prediction problem can formulate as the optimization problem, like subject to after the input SI, F, and noise vector delta, the YI element of the output is less than the Y target element of the output, which YI is the correct label of SI, and Y target is the incorrect label. We want to make the F theta mischaracterize. That is to say, F theta, we subject to F theta will mischaracterize and minimize the norm of theta. And the defense again, epsilon non-bounding adversarial attack can be considered as the optimization problem like subject to long of delta is less than epsilon. And after the input SIAD delta, we want the yi's element is always greater than the y target element. Hence, we minimize the yi's element minus the y target element. If this value is always is always positive, then the difference is a success because like subject to f theta is less than epsilon, the yi element is always greater than y target element. And we talk about our network assumption. For simply, we consider f theta from RS to RL is a robust neural network. And f theta is a k-layer neural network. Each layer combined with two sub-layers. The first sub-layer is a linear function. We multiply to wi and bi a vector. Wi is a matrix. And the second sublayer is a Reduce level. And the input is v1. Input s is v1. So the input v1 will multiply w1 first and add b1 and go to the reduce layer and multiply w2 and plus b2 and so on. The output will be ZK hat. And we rewrite the equation 2 to equation 4. The difference problem on our network assumption is like is only different from equation 2 is like we change our f theta of x to ZK hat. And y star is the correct label of input, and y tag is the incorrect label. We want the attacker will want the f theta to misclarify. And the y star element minus the y tag element can be y. Can write with the form of C transpose multiply ZK hat. And the C is equal to EY star minus EY target. The suggestion is the same, is same as equation 2. In previous example, we have two challenges. The first is like f theta the star made a convex set to a convex set due to reduced networks. We will explain in the following page. So the optimized problem of will be C transpose ZK on a non-convex set. Epsilon. And the second difficulty will be the optimization problem is too difficult since the network assumption complicates the condition like the problem subject to. Hence, we will be motivated to change it into a dual problem to get its law bound. The changing of dual problem is a technique to get a optimization problem of its law bound. But the Lagrangian duality can only apply on convex function if it is non-convex, then it's still hard to apply on. Hence, we need to construct a f tilde f theta to lay the function theta transpose tilde f theta with its minimum lower than the minimum of C transpose F theta and apply the Lagrangian duality on C transpose to the F theta. And in this paper, the method of making a to the F theta with convex symmetry is called convex realization. So we're gonna talk about our method, convex realization. The main idea of convex realization is simple. Since we talk about our input goes through the D network F theta, the output at the epsilon will be non-convex. So we consider on a convex set, which the previous output is a subset to the convex outer bound.
So there is a problem about this convex outer bound, because when your output set is bound, the output set is larger when you apply this bound. So if the adversarial, if it fails on the defense of adversarial attack, however, in the green part, it may fail, but in the blue part, it may success. So I think that this convex outer bound will lose some precision if you verify the robustness of this neural network. So
yes.
How can you guarantee the precision if you apply this convex outer bound?
Yes. So we just let the restriction become larger, and thus the minimum will not change.
Yeah. So you should make this bound as tight as possible. For example, I think that this is not this bound essentially can be tighter if you connect every point to if you just connect every vertex to make a convex set, it will be smaller than the green part. Connect every vertex of the blue part. The blue part is a something like a star. If you connect every point of the angle of the star, and you can make a tighter convex, you can make a tighter convex set than the green part. Yeah.
Yes. Yes. So the maximum of the green is lower than the maximum of the blue, since the green region is bigger than the blue region.
Yes, but I think that is not the smallest convex set to bound this blue part. It's still a little bit larger. So can you guarantee that your output is the smallest possible convex set to bound your output output set. Can this guarantee be true or not?
Yes. So to start the mathematically part, we define something first. So for V1 and V2 in Rn, we say like V1 is greater than V2 in Rn if every element in V1 minus V2 is positive of or zero. Like to say every element of V1 is greater than every element of V2. Every element of V1 is greater than the corresponding element of V2. Yes. So since the both linear function and the root function are bounding operator, the bounding operator is like if the input is bounded and the output of the bounding operator will be bounded. Yes, so the linear function and the root function is bounding operator. And given the network parameter theta and delta s and epsilon, we can compute the upper bound ui and lower bound li in each layer. That's to say the ui is greater than li hat and the li hat is greater than li. And with this bound ui and li, the root function can be replaced by a linear function and the bound in each layer is still the same. This phrase is not trivial. It can be shown in the theorem 1 and theorem 2 in the paper. But in this talk, we will not prove the theorem 1 and theorem 2. We will just introduce the linear function we found in the theorem and check in the necessary condition. But roughly speaking, the theorem 1 is considered the lower bound in the convex relation restriction. We can see like the left figure is the root function and L is the lower bound, U is the upper bound, and the convex relation restriction is like we change the root layer to a restriction, which the region is this triangle. And the theorem to show that if we replace the root function to the linear function, the linear function is the right one. And the lower bound of the replacement is also the original one. We can see that the linear function is also in the convex relation restriction. And if we replace the root to the linear one, the minimum of this function is lower than the minimum of this function. And if we replace the root to the linear function, we can apply the Lagrange duality function simply. So we will check the necessary condition we taught previous. So for Li plus 1 is the root of Li hat. The necessary condition is the equation 5. Equation 5 involves three conditions. These three conditions depends on the UI and LI is positive or negative. the first tag is the first k is like the ui is less than zero, and the second case is like li is greater than zero, and the third k is like ui is greater than zero but li is lower than zero. So a first k, it just be the negative part of the red rule, and the second part it will be the positive part of the red rule, and the third case will be the part involved the critical point of the red rule function, and
so I have a question: why did you need to classify the lower bound and upper bound into these three cases? Why they cannot be unified into one case? What is the reason to classify them into these three cases?
Oh, you mean like why we told the function, we told the inequality in three cases?
Yes.
You mean it right?
Yes. What is the reason?
The reason is like we will change the red rule function to equation 6. The equation 6, the first two conditions will be the same, and the third condition we will change the red rule function to the linear function. So in previous page, we only change the red rule function to the linear function in the third case. It's like u is greater than zero and zero is greater than l. So we pair the figure as u zero at all in this page. So this convex relation restriction will only apply on the third case. Not the two case, not the previous two case. So
okay,
we can see like the li plus one j value is still same as the red rule as the two case, so zero and still the same. The less is the red rule in condition 1, 2, and the convex relaxation will only apply on condition 3. That is to say, if we define the high dimensional rectangular set in layer I as CI hat, the set is described as which less than UI and greater than LI, and define the imagery of LI hat through red rule function as LI CI plus one. Hence, we can see like the imagery CI plus one is also the imagery of HI, and HI is the equation 6. The equation 7 and equation 6 is same. So the CI plus one is the imagery of the red rule and the imagery of the linear function. Yes, HI is a linear function. It can be write as the form like we multiply a diagonal matrix and plus a vector. The diagonal matrix and the vector value will be the next page. Precisely, if we define Ji, the dimension in the I layer, J is from 0 to Ni minus 1, and we will define three partition of Ji, the II plus, the II minus, and II. II, the II plus is corresponding to the first K we talk about, like the upper bound is less than 0, and the II minus is the second case we talk about, like the LI is greater than 0, like lower bound is greater than 0. Sorry, there is a typo. The LI is greater than 0 is II plus, and the UI is less than 0 is II negative. Sorry.
Yes, I know. But there's a problem. If both of LI and UI, or if one of LI and UI is 0, which set does it belongs to?
Oh, sorry, there is a second typo. The equation I miss the equal. So if one of these four increase, I is also have the equal. So if one of the LI or UI is 0, LI is less or equal than 0, and UI is greater or equal than 0. Sorry, there is a typo. And thus, the HI can write with the previous linear form we mentioned. With DI is the diagonal matrix, then have the this form, and beta have.
So why DI, they should have two identical index, DI, JJ. So why they should have two identical index?
Oh, DI have two index because DI is a matrix.
Yes, I know, but there are two J in the subscript, two identical J. So it
means like the element of in J color and J row.
Okay, so it's a diagonal matrix, right?
Yes.
Okay, I see.
So the both the rule function and the linear function HI makes CI head to CI is a necessary condition. And the GI plus one, the linear function.
So I have another question. Please go to a previous page. Yes, if it seems that DI is a diagonal matrix, so only non-zero element is in the diagonal and the other element is zero, right?
Yes, we only have non-zero element in the diagonal.
Yeah, so why So why do you use a matrix? If you just contain, okay, I see. Yeah, okay, that's another problem. I see.
Yes. Okay. We can see in equation 7. Zero is multiplied by zero, and the same is multiplied by one. And this is multiply a number and add a number. So write in this form. So the reroute function and hy match ci to ci plus one, and the gi is the linear function made to make ci plus one to success of ci plus one hat. So the F theta, the reroute based neural network defined in equation 6 with the output F theta of x equal to dk hat in ck hat. If the ck hat is the subset to the set like the I star element is greater than the y tag element, it means he always correctly classify. Then the neural level is robust again, epsilon bounded adversarial attest. Likes to say the of data it will not misclassify, is correctly classified. And we construct a linear function tilde f theta. Like we just replace the reroute layer as the linear layer we mentioned. And the input is still s equal to d1, output is still dk hat. And we can know like tilde f theta map c1 to success of ck hat. Since tilde f theta is a linear function, yes, tilde f theta is a linear function. It just since every layer is a multiple, is a linear function. So the f tilde f theta is also a linear function. So,
actually, I have a problem in your previous page. So, how can you guarantee that C hat to K is still a convex set?
Oh, because CK hat is the set less than UI at less than UK and greater than LK. So it is a high dimensional rectangular set, and the rectangular set is a convex set.
Yes, so after it is passed through a reroute function, it is still rectangle or not?
The reroute function will map to a subset like is not convex.
Yes, but you use a convex outer bound to replace the rectangle, so output can be a convex set, but CI is a rectangle, but CI plus one may not be a rectangle, it may be convex. It may not be a rectangle, but does it still a convex set or not?
CI plus one is still the rectangle because it made a rectangular set through reroute function. So reroute function is like, if we can see reroute function if a cross interval made to a reduced function, then the output is also a cross interval. So the rectangular set will made to another rectangular set in the output.
Okay, I see. So the output is still a rectangular set.
CI and CI hat is high dimensional rectangular.
Okay.
So A is F2 dot, two dot F theta is linear function. So it can write with the form AS plus B. And precisely, if we define WI multiply DI by LI, and LIJ is WI multiply, is LI multiply LI plus 1 to LJ, then we can write A and B in this form. This is just computation. We just computation each layer. And the A and B will be the function of this variable. So we can apply Lagrange duality on F2 dot F theta. And 2 dot F theta is very simple. It just AS plus B to get a lower bound of the optimization problem in equation 4. The equation 4 is the defense problem of the adversarial attack in our network assumption. So to talk about the Lagrange duality, we review the Lagrange duality is like if we subject to fi of x less than 0, and we may minimize f 0 of x, then we have a optimal value t star and a domain like fi of s is less than infinity. Both fi of x is less than infinity. Then the Lagrange dual function g from Rn to R for lambda Rn is defined as the infima of f zero of x plus the summation of lambda I multiply fi of x. And the Lagrange dual function have a property like if the lambda is greater than 0, then the function value is less than the optimal value of the original optimization problem. We call the original one the primal problem. So we just simply apply on the f theta of s is as plus b, and the easy to compute like the dual function g can be write in equation 16, and we apply the dual function of and we apply the property of dual function like for lambda 1 and lambda 2 is greater than 0, the maximum value will happen at the set C A transpose minus lambda 1 plus lambda 2 equal to 0. This is trivial because only when CA transpose minus lambda 1 plus lambda 2 is 0 is the critical point. So the maximum value will happen in this set. And we just need to find the lambda 1 and lambda 2 greater than 0, satisfy this equation. This is very simple. We just let lambda 1 star be the positive part of CH transpose, and the absolute value of the negative part be the lambda 2 star. Then the lower bound you can find is this value, the equation 18.
Okay, I see. So this is more simple. Lower bound, if you transform the primal problem into a dual problem, and you can, the dual problem is much simpler than the primal problem, right?
Yes.
Okay. And I have another question again. What is the motivation of this adversarial attack framework? So why is there any application or not?
The application is like we can for a label precision problem, we want to check our network is robust or not. We can apply this method, and we will get this low bound. If this low bound is positive, like means this mismatch value is also positive, so the defense is success.
Yes, but the problem is if this is negative, the actual network may be positive, or the next, if this outer bound is negative, but the actual output of the network may be positive or negative, right?
Or you say like with the low bound in equation 18 is negative. If this will have a trend line, the network is still robust.
Success, yes.
Yes, it may happen. But if this value is positive, then the network is also robust. But this value is easy to compute.
Yes, I see. But it may misclassify some kind of attack. So how can you guarantee that this, is there any gap between the actual output and your bound? Can you quantify how much example belongs to the region in which the bound is negative, but your network output is positive? How can you calculate the amount of this sample? Is this possible to calculate or not?
If we want to see like this bound is strong or weak, we can see the experiment of this paper.
Yeah. And so is there any analytical method to analyze this bound is tight or not?
I think this bound is tight enough in the experiment.
Okay, so you only have experiment result, but does he have any theoretical analysis of the bound is tight or not?
Pardon, could you ask again?
Yes. So you only have, so in this paper, they only show that it's prevalent to show that this bound is tight, but is there any theoretical analysis to show that the bound is tight?
This question is difficult to answer, so we only say the bound is tight through the experimental and find a more tight bound will maybe the work in the future.
Okay, I see. Okay, so is there any others to have any questions? Okay, so I have another question. If you, since this work is your master thesis, if you want to improve this work, how can you do? Do you have any possible direction to improve this work?
To improve this work, you will have, we will have two kinds of future work. The first kind is like to apply on more complex F theta. And the second work will be to find the tire bound.
Okay.
But I think the first kind of work is simple because the bound we find in this paper is just change the rule to a linear function. And apply a dual function, and the dual function of the linear is strong duality. So we only have the gap between the real function and the linear function. So I think the trying to research on the complicated network is much easier.
So what kind of complicated network you are going to extend to?
Maybe we can extend to more the CNN network or the attention layer.
Yeah. But the problem is the attention layer involve something like softmax. Is it possible to extend this to use a convex outer bound for softmax or not?
I cannot answer this question today. But the attention layer will not only use softmax to be the only possible, it will replace by rule in some cases. So in attentional layer, I need to find like the case we can prove.
Yeah, yes, I don't know much about attention, but I think that attention is for normalization, so it's still need, and you need to normalize attention. So you do, if you just use your do, it cannot normalize the attention. So I think that it's not possible to use your do to replace the suffix in the attention.
You means like if the network involves softmax and the
yes, there's something that you need to normalize that you cannot just use your do.
I have not seen about this question, so I will not answer it today.
Oh, okay, I see. Okay, is there anyone has any questions? Okay, if there is no other question, and thank you for participating in this meeting, and see you after next 2 weeks. Goodbye.